Everybody, welcome back. Falcon rebuilt 3 Gangs of Deadsville. As you can see over here, we're starting over here as opposed to in-game because there was actually an update to rebuild 3. I'm a little bit salty about it because the last 5 episodes that you guys have seen by this point were actually literally recorded a day before this update, which is beta version 70.2. So I literally missed the cutoff by like one day. Like, I recorded one day too early and I missed out on that update, unfortunately. What this update does is pretty cool. Like, it actually adds children to the mix of things, so I believe how it works. I'm not completely sure if it's 100% correct, but if you have any couples in your, I guess, society, they actually are capable of having kids. And then those kids, I'm not sure what their motive is going to be or what their plus or con is going to be, but you could actually have kids now, which I think is pretty interesting. So as we go along, if we have any kids, we'll be able to figure it out. And I don't mean, like, if we have kids, like me and you. I mean, if me and you want to have kids, fine, you know, just buy me a nice dinner first, and then we'll kind of work it out. But just to let you know, I'm not too fond of the idea of children, so it's going to have to be a really good dinner. But, you know, bullshit aside, that was added. And the other thing that was actually added I'm really excited about is that the items, you know, like the guns, the items you can carry, like in terms of accessories to bump your upgrades and stuff like that, they all actually have their sprite now. So, you know, not everything that wasn't implemented before looks like a binocular anymore, or a telescope, whatever it was. They actually have their own sprite now, which I think is actually pretty cool. It's going to add a little bit more to the feel of the game. So, the game's coming along pretty nicely. I'm actually happy about that. So, all that said and done, let's get into the game here. We have to continue, if I'm right. Now, ally or eliminate 2 factions. So, obviously, we've been going along with the ally with the pig farmers, but we've been trying to eliminate the Luddies over here. Any particular reason why? No, not really. I mean, they're just hippies. They're hippies and they're mad. What the fuck is this down here? Whoa. Hey, this is new. I didn't see that I missed his last episode. I don't know. It's been a few days since my last recording, so you'll forgive me. The Luddies, Saboteurs, 0% danger. The suspicious Luddy agent must be planning some kind of sneak attack. Okay, so this is something to be expected considering the fact that the Luddies are pissed off at us now. They're going to be coming at us with the, anger of a god here. So there's a dude over here, a Saboteur of some kind. I'm not sure if this is because we have the Saboteur perk now through the research or not, but, you know, I guess we'll figure that out. Other than that, let's see here. Everybody seems to be doing something for the most part, right? Is anybody freed up? Doesn't seem like it. We're gonna probably come after this guy, see if we can attack him, see if that works out or not. Over here, I think we're actually attacking the Luddies down here, if I'm right, right? Attacking the Luddies, yeah. How long is it gonna take? 1.1 of 2 days left, alright. Now, over here, the Saboteur worries me, but we have an upgrade over here with, Sasha Van Hoff, the greatest dude of all time. So, Sasha Van Hoff, let's see, you have an upgrade for us. Let me see what this is all about, my friend. Sasha's story. Alright, Sasha Van Hoff pulled me aside after dinner today. He said, "Hey there, how you doing? Me? I'm just happy to have solid ground under my feet again. I spent most of my life at sea in one boat or another." I'm not sure why I'm talking that way, but that's gonna be Sasha's voice from now on. "You never realize how much of a dead trap those things are until you get stuck in one of them crawling with undead? Meeting your maker by drowning or having—" I'm not even sure where this accent is going, honestly. Whatever. "Meeting your maker by drowning or having a zombie slowly peel off your skin? Ain't no choice of a man should have to make." So I like the fact that I'm over here just switching ethnicities as we go along here. At least switching, not ethnicities probably, but accents, whatever. Sasha can be get a new perk. What should it be? Let's see. So he's a scientist, so if we give him tough, what is this one going to do again? Less likely to die, but hard to make friends. Nope. First aid is going to give us reduced chance of dead on missions. Eh. And bookworm. Research burst, plus 2 engineering from books. Oh yeah, that's the one we want. So, yeah, we'll give you the research, my friend. So, we've hooked him up that now. Excellent. So you're level 2 right now, so you're still kind of doing your thing. And then we have Philip Pedersen, fucking Gothic Jason over here at level 3. So all these dudes are learning their trades, their tricks of the trade, whatever. You're fighting something over here. You're attacking the Luddies, and let's see. You have something going on. You're over here doing some bartend. No, actually, you're learning how to be a better leader. Good for you. You're over here bartending. Alright. So, the other thing I was told in some of the comments I've been reading recently is that the happiness is 0.30 per day, right? Actually, 0.3 per day. Sorry, I'm dyslexic. So, because a while back I made it so that we didn't really adhere to religion too much, I don't think that we get too much of a benefit from having a leader in the church. So instead, you come over here and bartend, my friend. There you go. You know, hang out over here. I don't think we'll see the immediate happiness change soon, but we'll have you bartend over here and you'll bartend over there. So we're going to have a bench, basically a society of drunks, and that's all right. I mean, what else is there to do in a post-apocalyptic world after all? All right, so everything else seems pretty good here for the most part. You are collecting wood, which is fine. I mean, never anything wrong with collecting wood. Assuming you have somebody to take care of it for you other than yourself. I'm a lonely man. All right, so we want the saboteur out of the way. So how are we going to do this? Well, you guys aren't in any danger over here, are you? Well, I'm not sure if there's even a danger involved. No, you're just tearing down their walls. All right. So keeping that in mind, the saboteur worries me, though. So let's see here. We're going to send somebody over here and just find out what this is all about. So let me send you. You can't do anything about this, can you? Enemy faction? Huh. Interesting. Interesting indeed. So we can't do much about this. Alrighty. So then you just come over here and just fight them. Continue fighting. Yeah, I'm not sure what this is all about. I don't think we even own this place, do we? I don't think we do. Yeah, this is part of their thing. But this guy's gonna probably come over here and try to cause some shit, so we have to keep an eye on it. Alrighty. So now let's go forward. See what he's about. Oh, he's moving. Oh, there's another one over there, too. We killed some zombies over on this side, was it? Apparently so. So we could essentially try to grab this for ourselves. What is this? Just a regular field? I'm not too crazy about the fields, honestly, but, you know, it's there. We have, for the most part, taken care of all the edges of the map, though, so we don't have to worry about too much about that. Now, over here, is this part of the pig farmers, or is this part of mine? Because I'm over here scavenging like I own the place. I don't think it's ours. I think it might be the pig farmers. So I probably shouldn't undertake that because I want to just keep the pig farmers as our allies for now, and then we'll go after the Luddies first, and then we'll go after them. And what is this over here? This Illuminati Tower? King Owen. War. Alrighty. Start a mission. What do you mean, start a mission? Oh, I can attack this area too, or I can meet with him. Nah, I don't want to meet with him. We can do some raids as well. Alrighty. Well, who is freed up? You are freed up, right? Okay. So this saboteur is actually kind of getting close to my researches over here. I'm not too crazy about that. I can attack him still too, so we kind of have to wait it out here for a second. Let me look around and make sure there's no zombie threats around anywhere. Doesn't seem like it. Alrighty. And this isn't part of ours yet. I think that might be Luddy territory? It could be. Alrighty, so what I'm going to do then is this extra fighter. Is there anything else here I want to fight? Maybe. What if I bring you over here for now? Like, for instance, here? You could hunt here. You could kill 26 zombies by yourself. Can you do this? 2.6 days? How's the danger level? 1% danger? Oh, you're fine. Alright, handle it. Alrighty, and now let's just continue going forward and see what happens now. Let me zoom out of here. Okay, this guy is kind of worrying me significantly. His shit's now turning red. What are you trying to do over here, my friend? Found materials. Stop here for a second, then. Oh, you found materials, but you're still scavenging about. Okay. We have Gustav over here, too. We haven't seen that guy in a minute. If anything, I want to kind of run into him, because we have a big income of food coming in, so if he could trade some, it'd be pretty good. Oh, my happiness just went down, actually. Even though we have two bartenders, so maybe the church thing was a bad idea. Keep preaching, then. Huh. Could have sworn people told me that was a bad idea if I don't have the proper perk for it, but okay. Now, this apartment building, I don't think we own this yet. Is that... can we, you know, grab this for ourselves if we wanted to? I'm not entirely sure. Let me try it, though. Let's see, who are my lumberjacks? You are? Okay. Can you reclaim? You can. You know what? Reclaim this area, then. Fuck it. I want it. It's just there. Might as well grab it. And let's go forward now. Red Luddy over here kind of worries me. Attacks on the Luddies went pretty well. Let's see. Using a few makeshift ladders, we scaled Luddy's walls and began hunting down the defenders inside. The fight was rough in our people, but the Luddies will remember the chaos we left behind if they know what's good for them, that is. And we have -3 faction strength. Okay, well, I mean, that was to be expected. So what is the ultimate goal from what we just did right now, though? We were over here, right, doing our shit? So is this like, oh, we could probably grab this pig farm now. Oh, shit, that would be pretty sweet. You know what? Who is my dude? Oh, you're trying to reclaim that? Yeah, fuck that. Let me have you reclaim this instead. Oh, you can't. Too far away. Oh, because we need to either grab this or this first. We have to reclaim this one or that one. That would make sense. Okay. So you're almost done over here, though, right? Yeah, you are. So you just continue trying to, you know, quote-unquote reclaim that, and we'll come back over this pig farm pretty soon. Saboteur here and here. It worries me when this thing is on red. What does that even mean? Saboteur 51% danger. The suspicious bloody agent must be planning some kind of sneak attack. Okay, you motherfucker. Let me zoom out of here a little bit. Alright, dojo reclaimed. Nice. Alrighty, so now we have the dojo. So over here, I guess you could currently come over here and probably train people to fight? If I was to be an astute guy, upgrade at stationary. Oh, the other thing is people have been telling me I should probably put up some watchtowers as well. We could do a bunker or a tower. Tower is 1, this is 3. But it probably gives you better defenses and whatnot. I kind of want to set up some of these because since we are warring with the Luddies now, I think watchtowers would be pretty ideal for our defenses here. So that's something we should probably consider. Let me have you come over here and try to reclaim this area first. And then, yeah, you finish reclaiming this, and then I'll probably have you come over here and probably start building a watchtower. You continue just grabbing some more materials for us because we're going to need some in order to build more watchtowers. And then all of my fighters are freed up now. They can't come over here, unfortunately, it doesn't seem, so we can't do much about that. I guess the other thing, what I could do, is since we own this, right? 51% danger. Okay. What the fuck is this? Bunker increases defense by 10. Do we have a bunker there? Or is that their bunker? Whose bunker is that? Let me have you come over here and just handle some guard duty to keep this guy from getting crazy with us. And I would love to, you know, put some guards over here because my people seem to be in danger. But the problem is if I do that, we're not going to be training anymore. Although, what I've been told as well is that, well, that's for researching, right? Yeah. Do I have any extra schools anywhere that I could just move these people and then put a guard right there? Schools. I think I only have 2, if I'm right. Yeah, 1 right there, 2. Oh, actually, I have 3 schools, but you're learning to be a leader here. You're learning to be a crafter, and then you guys are researching or learning to be researchers. Okay, so we can't do much about this one yet. And you know what? If something bad happens, that's fine. I'm kind of interested in what happens when this dude tries to attack. So, you know, that's probably a little bit risky. I'm interested to see what, you know, that causes here. So we found a saw. I found a saw in a huge farm that could be put to good use by one of our survivors. Equipped saw. Yeah, sure, why not? Oh yeah, and let me show you the items. So submachine gun actually looks like a submachine gun. Boomerangs look like boomerangs. Sledgehammers, everything looks like this particular item now, which is pretty cool, I think. We got some saws over here, top hats, binoculars, calculator, toolbox. So I'm pretty excited about that. I think it's pretty cool. So in terms of the saw, obviously this is for builders. I don't think... Yeah, we're done here, my friend. Thank you. I don't think, unless... Have I equipped you properly? You have a boomerang. What's your item? You don't have an item. So let me just hook you up with the saw then, because you are learning to be a... constructor anyway. You probably have an amazing item already, right, Harriet? I would imagine so. Yeah, you have a saw. So, you know, not an amazing item, but at least you have an item pertaining to your job description here. And then you... So I'm gonna make sure that they're all properly equipped here. Items, you have a hammer, which is actually +1 defense and +2 building, so you have the better one as it is. Alrighty, and then homeboy over here, what do you have? Wolf strength. Toolbox and a chainsaw. This guy looks like a total badass, look at him. Alrighty, toolbox is what? +3 building, yeah, you're fine. Alrighty, so we have a few extra saws if we want to trade them off or anything like that. And you're done with your scavenging, right? Okay. So, now that you're done with the scavenging, I guess what you could do... It's just a few places we could kind of still scope out for our items here. So you scavenge over here and get rid of that area there. And we'll go forward. My fighters are basically keeping track of these dudes over here. I'm just going to have them hang out there because there's really nothing else I really want to fight at the moment. Doesn't really seem like it. I guess what I could do is actually send another person over here to kind of help us out and make that go faster. Pig farmers are moving. Zombie mob spotted. Mother Nature's rat. A small earthquake gave Seattle a shake yesterday, and we're all okay, but Dojo over in the Pig Farmer's fort was badly damaged. They're asking for help with putting the thing back together. Seems most of their people are too busy fending off Zed. I'm guessing their walls didn't fare that well either. So I could send over a builder, need a level 5. Provide 10 building materials? Nope. Send builder and 10 materials? Yeah, you're out of your mind. I'll send you a builder, okay? The structure was rebuilt so quickly that it was like one of those Amish barn raisings, assuming they use power tools. Amish and power tools? I don't think so, Tim. The building may even be in better shape than it was before. Needless to say, Farmer Buck is very grateful for help. We got a +6 to the faction over here with the pig farmers, and that's pretty good. Okay, let's get... Yeah, I... What? What is this? Oh, this is... Whoa, hey, bro. We were finishing up reclaiming the apartment when Farmer Bucket from the pig farmer came by banging on a gate and was asking us what the hell we were playing at. Alrighty, so I'm going to convince him that it's okay because I have level 8 leader after all, and he's going to be okay with it. So don't worry, my friend. That's ours now. You don't even need to worry yourself over it. We're good people. I'll treat it well. Okay, so zombie mob spotted. That is over here. That is next to our new farm, so we should probably try to take care of that soon. Found ammunition. Where is that at? Found ammunition is, oh, from our scavenger. Perfect. And then zombies killed over here. But we have a zombie mob over there. You have an upgrade over here, too. Ashley Raimi has just leveled up. Nice rocket launcher. Seems a little bit fucking excessive now, doesn't it? Alrighty. One moment here. What is happening down there? Alrighty, sorry. My phone was bugging out over here. Alright, Ashley's story. We already heard the first part. We already heard the second part. Third part. I get back to finding our front door open with no sign of John. I went to check if the neighbors had seen him, but all I found was another open door and blood. So much blood. I never found my husband, but I know that wherever he is now, the Lord is walking with him. I would never wish ill on non-believers, but I can't help but believe we are being punished. I just try my best to live an honest, sin-free life, and I hope you do too. What perk should Ashley get? So yeah, she's really, you know, Jesus freak type of person. But that's okay, you know? That's her prerogative. Nothing wrong with that. Let's see, our happiness is 0.1 per day. Wow. Not looking too good in terms of the happiness there. Pacifist, this will probably, what is this, factions like you more but can't use weapons? No, you're one of my fighters, you have to use weapons. Peacekeeper, reduces chance of riots and fights, that could be useful. And firearms training, +1 defense on anything from pistols to machine guns. Okay. Let me give you the Peacekeeper one, just in case I don't want any fight. You know, remember we're having issues where a few of our people hated each other? Maybe the Peacekeeping thing will keep that from happening in the future, so yeah, we'll grab the Peacekeeper one. And then we'll send you to... over here. Well, technically I wanted to. Oh, the thing is that this isn't even ours. This is part of the pig farmers thing still. So yeah, we just let the zombie mob get closer before you even worry about it. And you, what are you doing over here, my friend? What are you doing at the bar? Oh, you finished reclaiming the apartment building. I got you. So you know what would be pretty cool if we did right now? We actually started working on these towers, you know? Actually, you could probably try to reclaim this bank. Is that part of the... Yeah, this is part of the pig farmers, I want to say, right? Or is this outside of their jurisdiction? Let me try to have you reclaim this. How about that? Reclaim this instead. And let's see, you are scavenging. You're freed up right now. Let me have you come and hang out with the other fighters here meanwhile. And then the saboteur is getting a little bit awfully close to us. How much time do you have left here? 1.5 or 3 days left, so that's still a significant amount of time. I kind of want to send my extra build over here to give her a hand. Harriet should probably finish this up really quickly for us, too. You know what? Come over here, Harriet, and let's speed this up a bit. 0.7 of 2.2 days? Yeah. Alright, so let's go forward. Zombie mob attack imminent. Stop game. Shit's going crazy right now. Building to sabotage. Oh, shit. So those maniacs, they blew it up. Damn, those bloody saboteurs to hell. Coming in here at night and setting fire to our buildings. We had to cancel the mission. Now that the site's a mess. Building destroyed, mission canceled. Stop for a second. What is he talking about? Oh, the pig farm! Oh, you son of a bitch! That was gonna be a really... I've never had a pig farm before, I mean. Both in real life and in game. What a motherfucker. Alright, we're gonna play it this way, huh? Okay, you know what? I have nobody to blame but myself for that. I thought that the assault was gonna come from over here, but no, they snuck up on me, these fucking saboteurs. You know, that's the reason why they're saboteurs after all. That's fine. Can you still reclaim this area at least for us, and then we'll, you know, build something out of here? God, pisses me off that we lost the pig farm potential right there. Alrighty, we have an upgrade over here though, so zombie attack imminent is over here. You guys are in the farm now? Perfect, so I could probably send my fighters over here now. Not all of them, but a few, just because we had to keep these people at bay as well. So what if we moved you over here, fight zombies? You probably can't do this by yourself, right? One day, 57 zombies, holy shit, that's a lot. Let's send her over here as well. We're looking at 36, that's still pretty high. Let's also send homeboy over here. We're in yellow now, wow. 57 zombies will probably be quite a bit of a threat, though, so I'm not too surprised about it. Let me send you as well, Queen Latifah, and 16%, alrighty, you know what? Let's send homeboy over here, too. Oh, God, come on, really? 13% danger. 13% danger, okay. What are you doing here? You do not belong here. You were reclaiming something for me, I want to say. You were trying to reclaim the bank, if I'm right. So you get back over here. Alrighty, the Saboteur is going to be hanging out right there, so I definitely need some protection here. Suddenly, I need more fighters. A while back, I was like, I have so many fighters, what's the point? And now it's completely different. So we have an update with Isabel Wang, of course. Isabel Wang, best chick of all time. Isabel Wang, can we, check you out here? I suddenly forgot how to do this now. Apparently, double-clicking it isn't really working. Isabel? There we go. We already heard that. We heard that part. Part number three. The dogs we had did their best to protect us from the Zed, but those things shoved their way past our mutts and tore into Mom and Dad before we knew what was happening. The dogs at least gave me and my sisters time to flee, but we soon lost track of each other. What with all the ravenous undead hot on our heels, I managed to get to the city, and it was all I could do to hide out till you lot found me. Isabel can get a new perk. What should it be? Animal lover. Extra skills and happiness if equipped with a pet. I still don't have any pets, so I seem that it's kind of pointless at this point. Team player. Improved skills when on a mission with at least three survivors. That could be pretty good. And good cook, which is bonus food production. Now, one second here. You are, if I'm right, you are a builder? Or are you a scavenger? Let me just give you good cook then. Yeah, because you are, you know, producing food for us anywhere from the farm, so that makes sense. Alrighty, so good on that one. This over here worries me significantly. We're not completely protected from that one. But we're going to go forward with it and see what happens. So, let's see here. We'll zoom out a little bit. Suddenly, I feel like I should have been researching some zombie protection thing too, because this over here is a little bit worrisome, especially with 57 Zeds. Gustav's is moving. Oh, shit. Okay. Nobody was hurt, right? The Zeds' number are no match for humanity's discipline. We met them head-on and sliced into so many pieces we made kind of a zombie slurry. 0% danger. And we have, what is this? Everybody's fine, defending the suburb. Good, stop for a second. Alright, so, oh, wait. Yeah, no, everything's fine. Kill one zombie. I don't think we need, like, that many people for one zombie. So what I'm going to do now is actually just send a few of you guys down over here. Sergeant Chambers, get your ass over here, Sergeant Chambers. You're going to help me out on this front. Keep that in green. Good. This guy's over here eyeing this area. Fucking saboteurs. And you're continuing to reclaim that. Okay. And then you're over here learning still. Alrighty. I don't need that many people killing one zombie, obviously. But I don't see any other immediate threats right now. So for now, we'll just kind of hold off on it. Go forward. Caught Saboteur. Oh. We caught a suspicious woman messing with our wall at 812 Mart today. She had a backpack full of gadgetry, but he won't tell us what it's for. Who sent her? What should we do with you? What should we deal with her? Sorry, I can't read today, apparently. Let her go, question her, or interrogate her roughly. We're gonna obviously interrogate her roughly, man. Unfortunately, the woman died during her interview with Sergeant Chambers. Sergeant Chambers, come on, dude, you're supposed to be. You know, that's not how you, you know, get questioning from people. Sergeant Chambers, when she attacked him with a hidden blade, but we discovered that she was a member of the Luddies that they sent over to plant a noisemaker to attract zombies to a weak point of our walls. I guess that's one less Luddy spy to worry about. So we lost -2 happiness because of the kill, and also -10 faction strain with the Luddies, but that's to be expected. Stop here for a second. Saboteur here and here. Ooh, what the fuck is this? Uh-oh, the Luddies attack force. These Luddy soldiers are well-armed and are coming to attack us. What we do to upset them? Well, I could imagine a few things that we did. But, yeah, they're getting crazy on us now. Alrighty, so this is going to be a completely different aspect of the game now. Okay. So, we were able to fend these people off over here, right? That was the Saboteur that we just talked about. So, continue sticking on guard duty here for now. This motherfucker here is going to probably ruin our school. So, you know what? At this point, you guys have to amster out of here. At level 7 leader, I think it's more than enough. Let me just plant you in. I don't think I have a second church, do I? I don't think I do. So, you know what? Just come over here and hang out at this bar. and continue intoxicating our people over here. That's fine. Let's see here. What's our happiness looking like now? Negative 0.2 per day. Eh. So let me move my dudes over here to continue learning. Engineering still. Yep. That's all good. Two of you guys, right? Yep. So you guys continue engineering. You're over here researching. Let's see. The other thing we can do meanwhile... Well, here's the thing I was told about my labs. People have been telling me that I don't necessarily need all these labs that I have. Only one is enough to have people research at. So what I'm going to do... Let me call an episode here. I am going to try to figure out what I want to make for these labs in place, and then we'll turn them into something else and just have all of our researchers in one area. And then probably destroy these ones and probably build something out in process. But I'm going to call an episode here. Shit's getting kind of crazy now with the Luddies. They are kind of busting my balls now. I need to learn how to deal with human attacks as opposed to just zombie attacks. So that's going to be an interesting thing to kind of worry about now. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. I will catch you next time.